Time magazine called him the unsung hero behind the internet. CNN called him a father of the internet. President Bill Clinton called him one of the great minds of the information age. He has been voted history's greatest scientist of African descent. He is Philip Emeagwali. He's coming to Trinidad and Tobago to launch the 2008 Kwame Ture Lecture Series on Sunday, June 8th at the JFK Auditorium, Union City Westin, 5 p.m. The Emancipation Support Committee invites you to come and hear this inspirational mind address the theme, Crossing New Frontiers to Conquer Today's Challenges. This lecture is one you cannot afford to miss. Admission is free, so be there on Sunday, June 8th, 5 p.m. at the JFK Auditorium, New East St. Augustine.
The late 20th century African history shifted from exploits in battlefields to the fight against apartheid in South Africa that was led by Nelson Mandela. I believe that by the mid-21st century, African history will shift towards contributions made by Africans in the continent and in the diaspora and made to human progress. The most important contributions that Africans can make include discoveries and inventions that will expand the body of human knowledge and that will make planet Earth a better place for all beings. I am the subject of school inventor reports because I contributed to the development of the massively parallel supercomputer. The parallel supercomputer demanded more from its inventors. I had to have an intimate understanding of the locations of every processor that outlined and defined my ensemble of 64 binary thousand processors. I had to have a deep understanding in 16-dimensional hyperspace of how to message pass my 2 raised to power 16 initial boundary value problems of mathematical physics and how to email the associated codes across my 16 times 2 raised to power 16, or 1,048,576 bidirectional email pathways, and how to route my 64 binary thousand emails to my 16-bit long email addresses. Each email address had no @ or .com suffix. In June 1974, I was programming a conventional supercomputer and using the machinery to sequentially solve a system of linear equations of algebra. Fast forward 15 years to the 4th of July 1989. I became the first person to figure out how to harness a new internet that is a new global network of 64 binary thousand processors and how to use those processors to cooperatively and simultaneously solve a grand challenge problem that is otherwise impossible to solve. An invention only occurs when its inventor crossed a boundary of human knowledge and that had never been crossed before. For me, Philip Emeagwali, I crossed into the never-before-understood frontier of knowledge of the parallel supercomputer that is the world's fastest computer. I was the first person to cross that frontier, and I crossed it at 8:15 in the morning of July 4, 1989 in Los Alamos, New Mexico, United States. Shortly after my parallel supercomputing discovery, the news headlines became African supercomputer genius wins top US prize. Without parallel processing, the supercomputer of today will not exist. I was in the news headlines because I discovered how to solve the toughest problems arising in STEM fields. I discovered how to solve real-world problems and how to solve them across a new internet that is de facto one seamless cohesive machinery that is a virtual supercomputer. My quest for the fastest supercomputer that will compute across a new internet, that is a new global network of 64 binary thousand processors, began on June 20, 1974, and began as a science fiction and as a theory or an idea that is not positively true. My supercomputer quest began in a singular central processing unit that was my metaphor for the computer, and that was a mere acorn or the seed of an oak tree. By the summer of 1974, and at age 19, I was only mentioned twice in newspapers. First, in a newspaper in Nigeria, and then in the United States. The name Philip, the name of a 17-year-old Philip Emeagwali, first appeared in 1972 in the science column of the Daily Times of Nigeria. The photograph of a 19-year-old Philip Emeagwali appeared on the cover of a local newspaper that circulated in the cities of Monmouth and Independence, Oregon, United States. That Oregonian newspaper article was published within 6 days after my interview that occurred on August 9, 1974. Taking a retrospective look, my quest for the fastest supercomputer began on only one central processing unit that was my metaphor for an acorn or the seed of an oak tree in the United States. My acorn blossomed into a mighty oak tree that was my metaphor for a never-before-seen internet that's de facto a supercomputer. That new internet was a new global network of 64 binary thousand tightly coupled and identical central processing units. Each processor operated its own operating system and shared nothing with its nearest 16 nearest neighboring processors.
Insightful and brilliant lecture.